line of credit and paid off your credit cards, your interest being at 14% a high, let's say, your income would go into this line, which is going to satisfy any payment that you would have here, bringing you down to $74.80, and averaging out your interest, you're going to be at about $100 for interest, so $75.80. Then the $382 that you had in credit card payments is now cash flow going into this, plus you had about $200 in cash flow already, so $582, let's say, for your cash flow is what's going to be working this down every month. Does that make sense?
It does, yeah.
Okay. What other questions do you have?
So it's better to do the credit cards first and then chunk, I guess, the car loan?
Well, it's not better, but it's kind of your only choice unless they give you the amount. Now, if they give you the amount you need to cover the car loan, then of course, you know, I would probably pay it off too, because you're going to gain that car payment every month. This too is only $11,004 that would work down with this, giving you the interest, you know, lower than it would be if you did the whole 36. Let's see what it would be. So $420 would be your interest charge on that whole 36 amount. So if you're gaining over $800 in cash flow, $400 of that's going to be going towards interest. So you kind of got to balance it out a little bit. Now, if they gave you $20,000 on this and you worked this down for 4 or 5 months and then you took a chunk then and started putting onto your car and then work it down 4 or 5 months to do another chunk, that is an excellent idea, especially hitting the car loan up front so that you're knocking off some of that interest that they're charging.
Okay. Yeah. I think the car loan goes through 2027. So yeah.
Okay.
And if I get additional cash flow by knocking out the credit cards, that's probably a good thing.
Yeah. Because you had an increase already that I didn't show in this cash flow. So you would do better automatically that way. Yes.
Okay. So with this, it would take a couple of months to knock out the credit card debt?
This one's going to, because like I said, you've got about $600 in cash flow that's going to be going in here and sitting. So let me see what that means. So you're talking about 19 months for a complete payoff. But like I said, if you had a $20,000 line and you paid this down for 4 or 5 months, then do a chunk onto your car, you know,
okay,
$2,000, $3,000, $4,000, or $5,000, whatever you wanted to do. The only other option that you have to move quickly would be going through the Money Max. And I don't know if you know what that is or not. No. But they are having a webinar right now that I'm going to transfer over to here in a minute. You're welcome to go there.
And what does Money Max do exactly? What is
Money Max takes the interest out of your payments. So if you're paying 6% for your car and 28% for a credit card, it averages it out to about 2% overall. So most of your income now is going to actually pay the principal instead of all of the interest. So that's how they have such a quick payoff date.
So would they then pay my debt and then I pay them? Is that how that works?
No, they set it up for you and it shows you a structure every week, every month of how to pay your bills and what days to pay on. So it's not invasive. They don't get into your personal business at all. You give them all of your numbers. It's a free analysis too. So they'll run the numbers, they'll show you how the system will work for you. And then if you're tickled to death with it, you can move into that group. But it's a really, especially for mortgages too, but like somebody in your situation, what is your total debt? Because listen, I had a lady run through it and she paid rent too. You have a total debt, 36. And then the 11, so about, but she had $70,000 in debt and she had no cash flow, none. And she'll be out of debt in 2.1 years. And that was everything. Wow. Yeah, it was crazy. She cried all the way through our session. I have the videos up actually of her because it was such a, from where she cried all the way through the session. Then she went through the Money Max program and then she got this 2-year payoff. She was so excited. She came back and she said, I want to do a video to tell people that this is amazing. So
wow.
We did the video. Yeah.
Is that the one that was in two parts?
Yes.
Okay. I think I saw that one.
Yeah, that's her.
Okay. And is that every Tuesday they have
that meeting? Yeah, Tuesday at 7 p.m. Central and it's Eastern, 8 p.m. here. What other questions do you have, though, about what you're looking at right now?
I don't, you know, when I sat down to try and do this, it just seemed a little bit more complicated. You're making it seem pretty straightforward and easy here. So it's just, you know, putting the income in once I get the line of credit. I asked them a lot of questions. I found a video that you had that you know, provided really good information about what to ask when you are going for a line of credit.
Right.
And it seems like that's why I opened a checking account with the credit union, is because I think there's no fees to transfer from the line of credit to the checking account.
Okay, yeah. Oh, that's great, because that's going to be very easy to use then. Well, if you don't have any other questions, it seemed like it, you already had it figured out before you came here.
I think it's just a different, like you said, different way of thinking. And so I was nervous and probably just needed to talk through it a little bit more. Okay. What do you do after, once you get debt free? I know, are you going to put videos up? I know there's a, you know, it's getting people out of debt first, but.
Yeah, we have, so I have some videos up. I work with another team that does infinite policies, which is what I do as well. And that's where I put my money now. So when you're debt free, it kind of gives you a place to store your money and then pull it out and use it as you need it. But it grows at compound interest. And you don't have to pay taxes or penalties to take a loan off of it and buy a car, for example, or whatever, once you get your funds built up. That too is what the line of credit serves me for, is I make multiple chunks throughout the year into these huge savings accounts, is what I call them, and they grow compound interest. Then if I need them, I pull them out and then pay myself back. So I've initially made my own bank.
Okay.
So that's a very good program. Whenever, you know, the Money Max, the link I just sent you, and it did go through. I sent it through your other email that you sent me your worksheet there. When you go, if you were to talk to Money Max, they also have those set up to where you can go ahead and start funding those policies as well. They're the only ones that I know that actually do that. Chris Noggle, I don't know if you've seen him online or not on YouTube. He has a lot of information regarding how those infinite policies work as well.
Okay.
So how old are you?
How old am I? 47.
Okay. So a 47-year-old, you would put in $470 a month is the way it would work, but it's set up to where you can pull it back out and use it again. So it's just really, it's something that I found that helped me fund for my kids' future. While I was protecting them, when I pass, then they'll have funds that come off of that as well. So I feel like I killed several birds with one stone just using those policies.
Okay. All right. I think that's it. If I email, if I have any other questions,
yes,
I can
please
email.
Please do. Okay. Yes. Feel free to.
Yes. I appreciate it. Thank you so much.
You are welcome. Thank you for reaching out. And yeah, feel free to email me and I'll just wait to hear from you if you need anything. Okay.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
You're welcome. You have a good night.
You too. Bye-bye.